had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
How did you know? Should we search the... Oh.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Pick up a coffee thermos. Okay. Can we fall? Oh! The overwhelmed enemies run to the light. What happens if we go backwards? Let's just see. Run.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
All your books have scattered. Who just has a trunk full of... Thermos again? Yep. Light spring.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
589. Rain Cove Point Egg Lighthouse. Add a new egg. Yeah, I want to look at this missing name. Jesus Christ! Whoa.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama. You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer. You're a joke. There would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories, because I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any good. Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Alright. That just sounds like my inner demons talking to me. Trust me, dude, I know all about that. Imposter syndrome is a... Oh! We're gonna stand up. Let's see. Oh, I have to actually stand up and do it. Couldn't read the QR code. Awesome. Probably the cool website. I really want to know. I'll try it one more time. Is it getting all foggy? They don't want me to do it. Fine. Bye.
You missed your deadline!
bust through this? No? Here, chop this gate down.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
Oh. Lame. Why is there a kettle on the ground?
How does it feel to die by the hands of your oppression?
We're running. Worn out.
This way, this way.
Hi. Hello. Who are you?
Hurry!
Got a Letterman jacket on.
It's me, it's me. I'm Stuart, remember? Quickly, get me signed. There's no time to lose.
Trapped. There was no way out.
Damn. Die. To die.
Follow the light.
I don't like that. Any
you are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
No.
That's pretty funny. I do not understand either.
I introduced you to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Mm-hmm.
This way. There's no time.
Okay, Jesus.
The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence.
That's a lot of ammo.
The darkness protects
him. Come on, dude, you can pick up more.
Only light can drive the darkness Jesus. Away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Really close to you. Oh!
Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun. Pick up the revolver.
Dude, shut the fuck up. I'm about to shoot you.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible light. Darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
All the light. Oh, I shot you. Stay down, bitch. Whoa, he's right there.
This is it, bitch.
Whoa! Run, oh, there's so many of them. Just run.
Just like.
Mm-hmm.
I can keep this up.
I guess I know where to go now. Doing fireworks again.
Easy.
Spooky.
Alan, wake up.
That was it.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Handsome. My food is ready. Oh yeah, she's isn't there. Doesn't actually say that on the. Hey, we're taking a ferry.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hey. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying that, I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an
interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this.
Okay.
Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you do have a lovely holiday.
It looks like you have a hearing aid.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. I see you made a friend. That's cute.
I took a photo
right.
Of you this guy.
Yuppies. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got to see
who has
the last laughs.
Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al.
I'm putting it on a boat.
Make sure you're doing okay, and you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
Aww.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
What do you got against me?
Come on, let's get back to the car.
I want to know what this guy's problem is. I'm just here giving you guys tourist money. Is that pretty cool, though?
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you, too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
I don't like their interaction.
I've forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose,
I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Oh, of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I'm glad to hear that.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Well, don't be an asshole, dude. Jesus.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Okay, these things are stuck to the fucking tinfoil.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake. Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get a fork at six.
Oh.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
She wants me. Get my sources. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna use a fork. I don't want it in my hands. Gross hands on this controller. That's smart thinking. She's just like standing there. Well, I haven't moved a muscle. Alright. Hooper, you're not getting any. Sorry, Bubba, doggies can't have this.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
What am I doing?
Do me Whoa. A favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
You put the lime in the coconut. Drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder
it
you.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
All right.
Yes. That's my favorite tune, Coconut.
Shut your mouth.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
My hammer.
Shut up, dude. Goddamn.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
What the fuck are you doing?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to
you
wait.
Don't wanna die,
I wanted to
you?
Find Stucky.
Worse.
To get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress
okay, this
was
is.
Me
they are Over so many influences from did. Twin Peaks. This is Log Lady.
I told Rose last week that she
That's that whole jukebox scene.
What
That's obviously the waitress and the coffee guy, the coffee stuff. Let's see if there's anything else.
Remind them to change the pumps. Just be vigilant. Darkness never sleeps.
You should listen to Log Lady. She knows what she's talking about. Cool, woman's room. Oh, alright. I find him in the woman's room.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Sounds like Chris Redfield.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Mm-hmm. See a creep?
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Come on, lady.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn, hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time.
Good to see you. Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
Sounds like your brother has, like, a...
The Andersons. They're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Calvin Lake Lodge.
Okay.
I'll be heading back to work as soon as Dr. Hartman gets here, Rose. Oh, but I'm not looking forward to the poison we have at the Park Cafe.
Oh.
Now this is what coffee should taste like.
Oh, Rusty, that's so sweet. I'll swing by with a fresh cup later on.
Is it a damn fine cup of coffee?
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Toodles.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
To what? The car?
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
That's stupid of me.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
It shouldn't be hard. You just have to walk a little bit.
Are you sure you read the directions right? It's nothing like in the brochure. It said near the lake, not on it.
Anything up here? We actually might not make it now. We can go up pretty damn high. Oh my god. Maybe I shouldn't have done this. Oh, this is where a car is. Oh. Look at that.
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Volcano? Where the fuck are we? This does not look like a place that would have a volcano. You mean like a tectonic plate? A well. Very nice. Sorry, honey, I had to go grab a thermos. guys. Oh, we're going to cabin. Basement window. Some wood for fires. Another basement window. Whatever you want to call that. A shelter. A basement. This is a shed. Cooper, please stop staring at me. I hate it. Whoa. So you get power. Okay. Awesome.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Oh, whoops.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it.
Oh, God. What's the point of a rocking chair here? A necklace? What the fuck is this? Why is that even there? Oh, my.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Oh. Did they do it?
The lights are on! Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
The island.
Shut
it was
up,
a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here. Once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
What? Very nice. We'll just throw this out the door.
Alice?
Right now.
Honey?
Hold on, I gotta... I've done something stupid. Whatever, I'm out of here.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Oh, do you? Please be pink lingerie. Damn
well,
it.
Hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
This creepy ass fucking
surprise.
Alice, what is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists. Maybe...
So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
What a prick. You left your wife alone in the dark?
Damn it.
Who's afraid of the dark?
Alice?
That's what you get. That's what you deserve.
Alice!
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 The ca- cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
I'm trying, I can't run anymore.
Alice!
Damn. She's getting murdered. Oh my god, jump in! Good man, alright. This is so much fun.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
So wait, that was another dream? Wait, what happened? Oh my god. Look, he didn't fall.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
I'm still confused on what happened. She fell. Don't touch those. My god.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Or scale down this mountain. Nope. Oh! Don't do that. Okay.
Among Alice's things was a book.
I can't.
The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Yeah, I know you didn't.
The gas station
like
was
you.
My best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
I feel like I'm supposed to like the main character, but so far, kind of a piece of trash.
Damn.
See ya.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
That's the dream you had earlier. You have found a manuscript pages. You can access them with the button.
Departure by Alan Wake.
Departure. Oops.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us. But the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim.
Glistened.
He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare. But I was awake.
It was a true nightmare. Dun, dun, dun. What are the little circles by these ones mean? Find this page in the nightmare difficulty mode. Oh, cool. Very pretty.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Maybe not. Can we pick up a mining helmet? Probably supposed to go up that log, but I'm on the lookout for thermoses. For some reason, that's the collectible. Very strange. Caution. Hazardous environment. All visitors must something with the office. Caution. It's a queen.
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident!
Don't repeat yourself, buddy.
Hey!
Jesus.
Hey, you!
Fail!
There's been an accident! I need help! Listen, deposit. I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Uh-oh.
Oh, hell.
Carl...
Oh, hell.
Ducky. To meet you.
Oh.
Non-refundable reservation deposit required. Fair and square.
Hold on, dude. Doing something. Okay. Is this his dead body? Oh no, that's someone he killed. Okay, what am I supposed to do? I don't have a flash. Like that. The important stuff, pick it up quickly. Oh god! Parkour.
It's the latest egg! No, two birds in contest.
Goodbye.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
This guy's. Okay. Oh, don't do that. Oh, I love this combo. How do you have this shirt and vest inflated?
During your trying it's the latest thing in Testably!
Yes!
Woman! Let you
right fall, Sheriff you. Station. Help me out.
Hello? Hello?
And see the sights and keep those cholesterol!
The spirit.
How do I know? Let's go outside, though. Oh my, he's lifting the building up! I'm out of here. That's actually pretty cool. Where am I supposed to go? Reach the gas station. What happened? Is it down? Oh. He tossed it down. Focus.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
I mean, the guy's a fucking ghost. I just hope that they don't put, like... Oh! Kick it! Oh boy! Get out of here!
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Fucking dick! Wrong, you little pussy. Oh my god, I'm dead.
staying to find out.
Okay.
There were more of them.
Pick it.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Sick of it. Fall into the lake, you jumped in after, and then all of a sudden you were in a car.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across.
Why are you even
trying to...
I
didn't even want to look at the water.
Look at it. Good. Okay. Where do we go? Looks like a briefcase. Nope, it is just. Look at that. Barry's arrival.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong. The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by... Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Pick up lithium batteries, only the best. Come on, my guy. I feel like I should be exploring more, but... I can't climb up this? Okay. Caution. Proceed at your own risk. The Lord Jean area. That's scary. What the hell is this? The dots on this. Oh. It's telling me where to go. Oh, so slow. Yeah, but I want to just kind of look around more.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Or is this the right way to go? There's no map. I feel like this is the actual way to go, so I'm gonna go back.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Oh, I don't know. Which way am I supposed to go?
Right. Taken. They're taken. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Hmm. Cute little rusty oven. Stove combo. Pick up a flare gun. Lithium battery.
Flare gun.
Open that chest. I don't want to use the flare gun. Okay. Hell no, we ain't climbing that thing.
I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
Because I know as soon as we kick that, there's going to be some little shadow ghost guys. So, just look at everything first before we kick that. Damn it! Got one of those hooks. Fucker. I'm glad that they actually die and they don't just like are stunned. Okay. See, I knew you should have picked up that hard hat. Oh, a shotgun. Wow, I didn't expect this to be like a arsenal. Type of game. Alright. Oh, it's one of these. Reach the path above. To that. Just get all juiced up. Excuse me. It's floating too. Move the log lift. Oh. I have a feeling that this is not actually how it would be moved. But what do I know? I don't work at a logger's mine. Once again, Twin Peaks again. The logger with the whole town. Make it. Look at these little tea kettles everywhere. Cute little patio chair. Throw it down the stairs. Hi. We'll come back to that. Yeah. I don't know, that's like the sign for a... a little, chest. So go fiddle with that radio.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'll keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air. Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
On his walkies?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured if, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog? Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Okay, I'm gonna run into a doggy.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Come on, come on. You fucking... What the hell are you doing? Man, I hit that doggy. Where's the doggy? Kind of cool how they do that. Let's get the bird in. Ooh! Cool. That's like a last ditch effort type of gun. Okay, come on. Yay! I'm throwing your shit at me. Shit. He's so bad, guys. Oh, there's two of them. Hello, boys. Ow. Ow. Wrong one, dipshit. Oh my fucking god. Ooh, buddy. Out of ammo. Safe haven. Oh, is this a dead end? I need some fucking light. Hey. Oh. Can't come in here, can ya? Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh, fuckhead. Where'd you go? Oh. He's right behind me. Whoa. Oh, mamma mia. What are you doing? What'd that do?
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode. Quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality. Poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
That was interesting. All right. Well, just a nice little 2 minute break there. Music and sound effects in this game are very good. Very good. Do I not need this? Come on, big boy.
No.
Unlike Stucky, you enjoyed inconsensible health benefits. Namely, you're not dead. Oh, so just beat him.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Come on, dude. We'll be fine. Pick up that chainsaw. A little scary. You're not gonna walk under that. See, like now, should I be looking for coffee cups? Like, honestly, oh, see, I knew it would be on one of these. Just gonna say, shut up, dude. Jesus.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Okay, good for you.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Hmm. Damn. $2.99. Remember that?
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
You don't think I fucking know? I'm looking around.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. Back, the story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It had been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Mm-hmm. Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head.
Why did she come out with her hand on her gun?
We'll figure this out.
Typical.
Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Yeah, he was like a million different ghosts.
candy-colored clown they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night, and just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right.
And episode, you know.
Then I